that. It grows in our country as well, but we've not taken advantage. It's a Thai flower. It's called Prajapta. Okay? It's a Thai specialty. They even infuse it and blend it into their recipe, especially desserts. So there's Mumbai Wine and Bandra, there's I think fitness restaurants like this who are working towards wellness and fitness source these flowers. So your question on caffeine is here. So when you finish all these leaves, anything which doesn't have a leaf is called tisan. Okay, a tisan means that it has either a fruit or a flower or a herb or a spice, but it will not have a leaf. Because if it's a leaf, then it will become a blend. This is pure flower fruit. So like we have a Turkey collection, which is all fruits. We call it the lover's tea. Then we have a Lamkil collection like that. But the Thai collection has pure flowers. So we're doing two versions as we close for the night, when we pair it with dessert. There's Rosella, which is also known as, popularly known as hibiscus. Rosella is again a Thai flower, pure flower, the big flowers we showed to you. And this butterfly ruby, which is anti-aging, like Shivani says, collage building and everything. So we're going to do this for you. But this is very beautiful, because what will happen now, you just see what happens. Okay? You're watching? So now see what is going to happen. Just watch the infusion. And it's very different from all that we've done for you. What color is it?
Blue. Blue. Indigo. Yeah. Not Teal.
Yeah.
More teal.
No, 1 minute.
Okay, what do
you mean? Can you see that the spout? That's a real color. So it's a blue infusion and there's nothing in it. Huh? There's no color, so don't get scared. There's no color, no preservatives. It's just a flower doing its magic. And then what happens over time, this flower turns from blue to dark blue to inky blue. And if I just press in a lemon, it becomes pink. So it's magical. So it's a lovely trick that we do. It's a unique leaf. I don't call it tasty, but it's got a great deal of antioxidant properties. So when you enter your, we have bright and early tea where we have all the chais and darjeelings, and we have manchin tea, which we have after hami, three tea sounds like this. And then we have our evening tea. And then we have something like this, which we call the quiet moment tea. So we brew this in a glass kettle, typically so that you can see the liquor.
I've seen this.
So like I said, it's important in what you brew your tea. And it's your ritual, it's your spa for the mind. And so you should just take care of whatever you have, you should just make it interesting. You don't need to go buying fancy stuff. But suppose you have a champagne glass at home or a wine glass, you can just brew it in that. You know, like what we sell in our Diva collection is something like this, is a burner. And if you're at work or at home and you're busy, all you need to do is, the leaf is there, just keep refilling water and keep it on that. So the tea burner just does the work of brewing it. You don't need a pantry service or a ritual. Anybody who tasted it? It is?
Nice.
Yeah, no taste. Who said no taste?
I love the color.
Yeah, I love the color.
Yeah,
but
it smells really good.
Yeah.
It smells really good.
So like they were telling us when we were doing the tastings for us in Thailand, the way the lady explained to me, the vendor who works for me, she said that you know, thousands of cells leave your body each day, and the new cells come in. What this does in the period of transition, it's building up all the oxidants for the body. And so it has a very scientific way of purpose. It's essentially, and it's, if you go to Thailand, you notice it everywhere. It's an iced tea, it's in there. You can see these blue looking desserts. So yeah, sure, you're going to, experience it somewhere in Thailand. Yeah.
Smells like lady finger.
Huh?
Smells
like liquid. Yeah. I want everybody to taste it, and I'll tell you what it is. Tasting.
Is this
something
like too much tea in a day, or is
that
something like that?
Of course, yeah. So, you know, there was this biochemist who actually became very popular in all the days. And it seems that there are certain basins of tea, because all that it did was drink tea, and before the kettle could become cold, his goal was it should be, you know, served in the end. So the point I'm making is that anything in excess is not good. So when we started out with anything, that you have excess of green, what it does to you. If you have excess of chai, or you know, you can't see. So yeah, anything in excess, anything, not only tea. But if you have tea sands, you're safe in the sense it's just a pure flower or fruit that you're drinking. And these have no chemical preservatives. And so the caffeine won't impair and come in the way, and nor will it affect anything else in the body. No side effects is what I'm saying. So too much of this is never a problem, of any of these tea sands. Now Shivani can serve the hibiscus also. So we have two Thai options which we've paired with the dessert here. And so this is what butterfly was. And this is something that most of you have tasted when you're enter, in case you want to taste it again. This is very popular with the youth. It's hibiscus, it's called. But its origin is in Thailand. It's called Rosella. Or Roselle, as they call it. And Rosella is had hot or cold. But when you serve it hot, it becomes, it's called Jamaican. So right now, what I'm serving to you is called Jamaican. That's a name given by them, coined by them, by their ancestors. And if I were to make this into a cold iced tea, it would call us as hibiscus.
So all these teas can be served cold also?
Can be?
Served cold.
Yeah. So any leaf that we're serving today or in our menu is hot or cold. Except for, of course, the chais. This was the last tea of the day. And like I said, there's tea for each part of the day. We've been saying that since 2006 when we started. Our menu rides on tea for each part of the day. And each leaf resonates feelings. So that's why, you know, it's like rejuvenation, relaxation, happiness, joy, and these kind of feelings. Taking that forward from 2006 to now, essentially, our tea is classified into three categories. And that's why if you watch the video, it was about declassifying the leaf. We retail about 50 plus teas and it's divided in three parts. So there's connoisseur for people who know their leaf well. Maybe Girish here fits the bill. There's romance, which is not about, you know, having a lover, etc. The thing about romance is the, like you had a green rose. It's about having these very interesting blends which kind of help you romanticize life in general. You don't need a person to make you feel romantic. You know what I mean? It's about just loving life. So that is where the origin of our romance series is, and in that we have certain types of blends from every country. So right now we're retailing teas sourced and curated by me from China, Sri Lanka, Turkey, India, and Greece. And Greece is my favorite because Greece is not known to make teas, but Greece, we have artisans who are selling us and we're sourcing those herbs. There's a place called Pilos from where we get the herbs. So there's rosemary, thyme, and sage that I'm you know, selling afresh as a tea to be brewed. And these are essential in terms of pairing it with your continental or Italian drinks. So they have you know, those digestive properties. So yeah, so taking that forward, it's divided into three categories, and the last one is the healing chai that you saw. So, you know, you had an Assam, in that we have a series like vanilla, there's breakfast, there's your ginger, and these are organic blends. Yeah, and lemon rice. So, the last question for the day is, for all our viewers watching us, what was the fifth tea that you had? And basically an infusion, doesn't have any leaf in it, made of fruits, herbs, flowers, and spices. So name it for me. So yeah, so thank you.